Hi, how are you guys doing? Good? So I quit soda this week. It's been a week. It's kind of like saying hell's frozen over, avoided a stock market crash, and Justin Bieber quit music. Falling, right? Yeah. So, yeah, I quit soda. It's difficult. I had a dream last night. This is true. I was sleeping, and during the dream, I went to a kitchen, sat at the counter table, and drank a soda. That was my dream. How sad and pathetic is my life at that point? Towards the end of the dream, my friends walked in, and I'm like, whoa! Then I woke up. So, that was fun. Jeez, let's see here. Lots of new material tonight, so bear with me. Okay. Okay, let's see. Soda. Oh, guys, I've been working out. Ways to avoid exercising. Come up with 6 different ways. I forgot them all except one of them involving avoiding the gym. So, working out. It's great, great stuff. Guys kind of remind me of rehearsing at home, you know, with silence. Thank you. Appreciate that. I tend to overanalyze my material as a comic. I read somewhere about doing comedy. It says, if you overanalyze material, it's like running a half marathon and then running backwards every 15 seconds to see how you're doing. Jokes on them, I don't run. How about that? So, I have a strict no running policy. Do not do it. My refrigerator stopped working or running this week, which is great. It gives me a chance to avoid chasing it. So, that was a variation of a dad joke. My dad would love that one. But no, I quit. I will not run in any condition. Day or night, rain or shine, chicken or egg, Hanukkah or Yom Kippur, I won't do it. If I was in a horror film and there was a killer chasing me, and in order to survive I would have to run, just kill me. You know, just do it. I wish there would be like a little mobilized scooter in the corner. That would be kind of nice, just to scoot my way to freedom, you know. You guys think about that all the time, I'm sure. Scooting. Lots of scooting. So I'm a little cynical, and I'm a little ignorant, too. I'm signorant. That's a word. I'm signorant. A lot of people are, especially with politics. People are just like, this country's going in the crapper. It's like, do you know who's running for president? No. What, Bush is president again? Don't know. That was my politics joke for the night. Didn't work, that is. But no, I'm cynical. A lot of people feel entitled to everything, I've noticed. Old people feel entitled to stuff because they were in Nam, like they deserve a free meal at Hoo-Ha. No, what? It's like, so what? I had tough times. I was made fun of in high school. I'm entitled to a hot girlfriend, am I right? Guys, right? So I'm single. But I'm okay with it, you know? I'm kind of a compulsive, intermittent commitmentophobe. I always, occasionally, am afraid of commitment. I worry about it all the time, sometimes. But no, it's like, I'm taking my time because, I don't know about you guys, but I don't want a girlfriend that sucks. Wait, I take that back. That was mean, wasn't it? That was mean. I'm a little mean. I'm a mean-spirited guy. I'm a ne'er-do-well. No good, Nick. I have bubblegum and butt whoopings, and I'm all out of butt whoopings because of all the beatings I do. Because I'm so mean. Thank you. So I'm going to close with an impression. Who here listens to Randy Newman?
Yeah.
Yes. I was hoping all of you would be like, yes, all the time. Just to figure it out. Is this from Toy Story, you know? Strange things happen to me. That guy? I'm going to do an impression of Randy Newman singing Alanis Morissette's You Ought to Know. And I'm here to remind you of the mess you left me with. It's nothing to deny me of the cross out there that you gave to me. You ought to know that you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road is rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, just remember what your old pal said, boy, you Thank you, I'm Zach Dresch.